time, oh Lord, hard time, oh well, the mother is children have a hard time, oh well, the mother is gone. This train, no carrot, no gambler, this train, this train. This train, no carrot, no gambler, this train, this train. This train, no carrot, no gambler, no carrot, no rambler, no midnight gambler, well, this train.
Thank you. I showed her my gun and I tooted my horn. Gonna find a possum in the new ground corn. Olga barked and I went to see. Holding a possum up in a tree. Old Blue's feet was big and round. He never allowed a possum to touch the ground. Yahoo Blue! Possum, possum growled at him. I shook him down, Blue took him in. I baked that possum good and brown. Put them sweet taters round and round. Come on, Blue. You can have some. With a silver spade, lowered him down with a golden chain. Everything kind of call his name, Yahoo Blue. You good dog. Thing I want you to know, Blue's gone to heaven where the good dogs go. Only one thing troubles my mind, Blue's gone to heaven, left me behind. Yahoo Blue, I'm a coming there too. Heaven, first thing I'll do, gonna blow my horn, blow for old Blue. When I hear that blue dog bark, Blue's treat a possum in Noah's Ark. Yahoo Blue, you good dog, you.
Like Danville Girl? Is that a different song? I'm going to do an Australian song next about a man who spent a lot of time in places where they served things to drink. His name was Bluey Brink. That's why he drank so much, because Brink rhymes with drink. Sad example to everyone. There once was a shearer by name Bluey Brink, a devil for work and a devil for drink. He could shear his 100 a day without fear, drink without winking 4 gallons of beer. Now Bill Jimmy, the barman who served out the drink, he hated the sight of this here Bluey Brink, who stayed much too late and who come much too soon, at morning, at evening, at night, and at noon. One morning when Jimmy was cleaning the bar, with sulfuric acid he kept in a jar,
mama yelling and bawling with thirst. Whatever you got, Jim, just hand me the first. It ain't in the histories, it ain't put in print, but Bluey drunk acid with never a wink, saying that's the stuff, Jimmy, will strike me stone dead. It'll make me the ringer of Stevenson Shed. Well, all that day long as he served out the beer, poor Jimmy was sick with his worry and fear, too anxious to argue, too worried to fight, seeing the shearer a corpse in his fright. Early next morning he opened the door. There was the shearer asking for more, with his whiskers all singed and his eyebrows deranged, and holes in his hide like a dog with the mange. Says Jimmy, well, how did you like the new stuff? Says Bluey, is fine, but I ain't had enough. It gives me great courage to shear and to fight, but why does that stuff set my whiskers alight?
What?
I never
remember. I have to think about that for a minute. And see whether I feel like singing it tonight or not. It's a dangerous sort of thing to sing, you know? Why do you want to hear it? The Old Maid's Lament. A request.
shells in the ocean will be my deathbed. The fish in deep water swim over my head.
Now I'm going to sing one of my favorite songs.
Gets up a cuss in the day of his birth. Now I know there's old pony
no. All right. I shall do so.
This is a song called Sweeney, Todd, the Barber.
Special request. For all meat eaters, for all carnivores in the group.
In Fleet Street, that's in London town, when King Charlie wore the crown, there lived a man of great renown. 'Twas Sweeney Todd the Barber. One shave from him and you'd want no more. He'd feel his razor sharp, then tumble wallop through the floor and wake up playing a harp and singing Sweeney Todd the Barber. By gum, it were better than a play. Sweeney Todd the Barber, I'll polish him off, he used to say. His clients through the floor would sing, but he had no fear of the hangman's rope. Dead men could talk with their mouths full of soap, said Sweeney Todd the Barber. Now underneath the shop, it's true, where the bodies tumbled through, there lived a little widow who loved the Barber. She made her living by selling pies. Her meat pies were a treat, chock full of meat and such a size, 'cause she was getting the meat from Mr. Sweeney Todd the Barber. By gummy, were better than a play. The first square meal he'd ever had, a hot meat pie made out of his dad. My Sweeney Todd the Barber.
It was Saturday night in old Sweeney Todd's shop. His customers sat in a row, while Sweeney behind a screen shaved some poor mug, and his sweetheart made pies down below. Though none were aware it were cut prices there, and they rolled up in twos and threes, and his foot got quite sore pressing the knob on the floor, and his voice went from saying, "Next, please." First the toff took the chair. He said, "Oh, my man, just a shave and a perfume shampoo, for I've just got engaged." Sweeney just pressed the knob and said, "There, now it's all fallen through." Next, a bookmaker said with his mouth full of soap, "They're all betting Fibridge today, so I bet I'll go down." Sweeney said, "So you will," and indeed he went down straight away. But what rotten luck, the darn trap went and stuck from an inch he'd forgotten to grease, and a customer there started calling out, "Please," just as Sweeney was saying, "Next, please." Yes, he ran to the door and he yelled out, "Please," he cried, "Please," 9 times of 10, but no policeman arrived. The very good reason the police weren't invented by then. But up came the brave Bow Street runners, hurrah! And he had to let many a pie burn, while they hauled him to quad. And next day Sweeney Todd was condemned to be switched off the Tyburn. And there on the gibbet he hangs in his chains. They do say a little black crow built a sweet little nest in old Sweeney Todd's whiskers, and sang as he swang to and fro, Sweeney Todd the Barber. My gummy were better than a play. Sweeney Todd the Barber, they buried him underneath the clay, and old Nick Carter up a Sweeney, I want a shave, and Mrs. Nick wants a permanent wave. From Sweeney to the
Mimette, ladies and gentlemen. Before we bring out, or rather before we start our hootenanny, we'd like to remind you once again that we have our regular hoot night here at the Blind Alley starting at 8 p.m. tomorrow evening, and we have about 13 acts to be presented here on stage, and you're invited down. Unless you have something better to do, and I can't think of anything better to do.